Vamos a ver cómo sale esta peleita ahí, a ver. Esta es de la... del undercard, de la pelea de... de Ghosty vs. Better B.
Now, the action has definitely picked up here in round two as Johnny stepped on the gas a little bit more here. round, so he's coming straight in with a straight left hand, coming up with the right uppercuts, and he's got probably a couple shots.
Yeah, he's got to bring his hand off that, off that straight line, kind of come in at an angle, because
Johnny's back to the jab. The jab set everything up in the first round, and helped him make his way in without getting hit. He was getting in and out, landing his combinations, and not getting touched. This round's a little different because he got away from the jab.
And the right hand for Rodriguez, he landed a couple times flush because of that. He's definitely picked up the pressure here in round two. I still feel Vargas has been in control most of the round, but definitely a better round for Rodriguez here.
Yes, I agree. I still think Vargas is very much in control.
Agreed.
But not quite as clear as the first one.
Shots that Vargas has been landing really start to accumulate as these rounds go by.
I think Vargas is going to have to put some hurt on Rodriguez, because this might turn into a very interesting fight as the rounds go on, if Rodriguez is able to keep up this pressure.
The pressure is what Rodriguez said was his bread and butter. He said, I'm going to try to box, but I know that standing in the middle is where I like to be.
I do, but very different rounds. I have Josue winning both rounds, but the first round was pretty much a whitewash. The second round, Rodriguez was actually in there, landed a few shots of his own, and put a tremendous amount of pressure on young Josue Vargas.
Good straight left hand. On the southpaw stance for Vargas, lands.
This is what I like to see out of Vargas. Distance, jab, use your footwork. He's got great footwork. He's got a beautiful right jab. When he uses that, it really shuts off the offense of Rodriguez.
More of a boxer, and he likes to. Oh, and he gets caught there with a big right hand from Rodriguez that backs him up a little bit to the ropes. I don't think he was hurt too much there, but he's got to be careful again. Gets caught in a counter line exchange. It doesn't seem to have his feet too steady right now. Like, he's going to lose his footwork.
Right hook there. Check hook by Jose Vargas.
Yeah, that's helped get him back some momentum here. As Rodriguez wants to continue to back up Vargas, wants to be the aggressor. His corner man was telling him, and he needs a left hand right here for Josue.
You know what I would like to see from Vargas? A little bit of level change.
He's
very straight up. He's kind of very linear, straight in. I'd like to see him bend his knees a little bit, drop down as he's coming in, and then on the way up.
Another left hand that's in there. And a good counter straight right hand.
Again, because his leg was going straight out, straight back.
Rodriguez blocking a few of that to those jabs, but that's okay. That's keeping that distance that was that Josue Vargas won.
Rodriguez is one of these tough, dangerous journeymen. You can see in his eyes, he's very determined. He wants to come forward. He knows what he needs to do.
When you say journeyman, he's been in the sport 17 years, long layoff, inactive the majority of that time, only 15 fights as a professional, not all the wear and tear you think you see on a 38-year-old fighter that's been in the game this long. Nice uppercut set up there from Vargas. He works his way out of those corners pretty well.
He's got great lateral movement.
Yep.
I really like when he gets on those toes and moves around. I used that jab.
Oh, and a good uppercut lands there. And a right hand, a little bit Vargas. Just like you said, Josue pulling straight back, he's getting caught.
Pulling straight back, being tall. Like I said, I'd like to see him change levels a little bit, meaning bend his knees, get down, get underneath shots. And there we're going to see this Josue fighting off the ropes, which he's doing quite well. Not taking any damage, tying his hand up, spinning back, and getting back to the center, exactly as you should be.
Doubling up on the jab and landing a strong left hand to Josue Vargas to start the round. And really, he's been able to set up that left hand beautifully when he throws it, probably more so when he doubles up on that jab. About her not getting careless. He senses Josue is in a groove and he'll start getting in that rhythm. on Josue that he wants him to sit down a little bit more when he's throwing his punches, try to get Rodriguez out of here.
Yeah, he wants him to walk him down, put a little bit more pressure. Wants to come up with his hands high, walk him down, sit down on his jab, and dig those body shots. He said the man's hurt to his body. He doesn't like the shots to the sides. And then the comic voice of Andre Rozier in the corner was saying, pop that jab, his man's tired.
And we kind of alluded to that ourselves in round five, so we're all on the same page as far as what we think. I guess we know a little bit of something about this boxing thing. As Vargas, beautiful uppercut. He's throwing shots from different angles now. That's something you talked about earlier in the fight, that he needed to do different levels.
He's actually a great combination puncher. He does mix that up really well.
Good combination right there, Lance Blush. Josue starting this round pretty strong here.
Yeah, he's doing what his father wanted. He's coming forward with his hands high, putting more pressure, and he's still digging that body. Here, pop, pop, pop first from his father saying that.
Translate.
His jab. Pop, pop, pop.
Right.
Needing the jab. Pop the jab.
Shake it out. Yep.
He's caught an elbow, so a little bit wide.
And good job turning Rodriguez there. He tried to sneak in a hook, but Vargas was too quick on his feet.
Actually, a good scrappy veteran will use their elbows to block punches.
He did it there, too, in that last exchange. Try to give himself a chance to win this fight, but he's not going to do that if he doesn't start letting his hands go wide. He's having a hard time catching Vargas.
Yeah, it just seems like they have different cylinders in terms of their output.
Oh, and a good counter right hand landed by Rodriguez, who pressed punch in a few rounds.
See, that's the range where he needs to be in order to get anything done. Outside, he's just not quick enough to catch those waves. On the inside, he's able to hit those waves with shots, but he doesn't keep.
I
think that was clean.
I think so too. I don't think that should have been. I don't think the referee should have interjected there. I think because Rodriguez turned his back, he wanted to, make sure that both fighters were there. But that's happened a couple of times in their exchanges. So that was a clean punch, though, landed by Vargas. That counts.
Yeah, great reaction by Vargas. Make man miss, make him pay.
Round seven coming up now, scheduled for 840-pound division. Still to come on our undercard, Jeremy and Joseph Adorno, the two Puerto Rican brothers from Allentown, coming up, and Julian Hammerhand Rodriguez, and, of course, hometown favorite, Sonny Canto.
That round was an interesting one. It was a little more exciting because Rodriguez actually landed a punch. You see a nice right uppercut here. They land on the inside. Still a round that Josue Vargas, I think, dominated, but he did get clipped with a right hand there on the inside. Pretty much the only punch that Rodriguez landed in that round.
Josue Vargas pitching a shutout here through six. Still to come on the main show later on tonight, 10 rounds welterweight, Abu Kaparov and Louis Collazo in the co-main event, and of course the unification fight, 175 pounds, Archer Beterbiev taking on Alexander Bogdan in our main event. This place will be packed come 10 o'clock. It's Friday, there's traffic, people are still at work, I understand. Appreciate those who tuned in and joined us on ESPN Plus. We see the monster Chris Algieri here as Josue Vargas bends the left hand to the body. That Rodriguez seemed to think was low, but it looked like it was right on the belt line.
Yeah, that looked like a unique shot to me.
Yep.
I like when Josue was able to pull out and then fire shots, make his man miss, but then still be in range to land the counter. Beautiful boss in his room.
Vargas is walking him down, turning him with those shots to the body. Strong left hand from Vargas lands. body, Christina, and I, he stayed true to that. As Rodriguez is just taking some punishment now that looks even like he glanced to the referee for a second, but Vargas is just pouring it on now. Much to the likes of his family and friends that have come here to watch him from the Bronx. Looks like he's going to let Rodriguez out of this round, but I'd be taking a real good look at him, even if I was in Rodriguez's corner.
Yeah,
one round to go.
He might stay on the stool.
Do they want to send their fighter out for another round? Rodriguez did land a good punch in that round. It's been a good punch here and there in a round, but just not enough.
But Rodriguez really, I mean, in that round, he put the pressure on, so he allowed himself to be in the mix, and you're going to get hit with some shots here and there. But for the most part, Vargas, with that left uppercut to the chin, was one of the first shots that hurt Rodriguez to the head. Following up with great body shots to the right hand, he's really letting his hands go that round, really pushing to get the stop.
Yeah, he did a good job of, you know, catching a lot of those punches from Rodriguez, too, in that round. Just, you know, Rodriguez is just not as fast as Vargas. And, you know, I think part of the reason why they don't want to stop the fight in the Rodriguez corner is that he's never been stopped before. They want to give the guy a chance to kind of go out on their shield. And I have mixed feelings about that mentality, but that to each his own.
Hey, I'm a fighter. I get it.
Yep, 100%.
If that's what you got, he's not undefeated, but he's never been stopped. So that's something for him to hold on to.
Hasn't been down in this fight. Hasn't been cut. Although it's been dominated for the most part. Pretty much, you know, every round, every minute of the round by Vargas, as we are now in the eighth and final round, 140-pound contest.
I think if Vargas goes out here, uses his jab early.
Oh, good right hand from Vargas.
Counters Rodriguez and then puts on some pressure, he can get the stoppage.
The referee is looking very closely at Rodriguez with each and every exchange.
Yeah, it won't take much.
Back to the stick goes Vargas.
Again, Rodriguez staying very calm, even though he's getting deep from pole to post at this point. To the head, into the body. Still looking for his single pot shots here and there. Cuts his little angles. Here in the corner of Vargas saying, yeah, he's just trying to survive, pop the jab. Some get back from Rodriguez, but for the most part, Vargas has been completely dominant in control from the opening bell.
And Rodriguez is tough. They came here and gave Josue 8 rounds and 38 years old, but you can tell in the way that you perceive how calm that he stayed. He's let his experience show through in terms of not getting too flustered in this fight. He just didn't throw enough punches. Just wasn't accurate enough in this fight to probably win it off the odds. But here's Josue putting on an onslaught here as we are under 10 seconds in the fight. And
Rodriguez still being tricky.
He's still Rodriguez. I mean, kudos to him. Still trying to give it a go. But a dominating performance from the prodigy, Josue Vargas. In a night that he paid tribute to Hector Macho Camacho. Didn't get that knockout as Camacho did in these looking trunks back in 1997 against Sugar Ray, but still would have made his
still a sharp
his proud. Yep,
and
yep.
For a young fighter,
title's proud.
It's good to get rounds.
It absolutely is.
Let's
He's
wait.
Only 21 years old. This is just fight number 16 for him as a professional. So you see both guys championships. At the end of the day, that's what it's about. And somehow he got cut. There's some blood now streaming from the eye of Josue. That must have just happened in
that last exchange.
Up until 10 seconds to go in the eighth round, there was no blood. And now he has a cut right on the left eyelid. And he's not happy. All right, let's send it up to Lupe Contreras now with the official decision.
Ladies and gentlemen, after going the distance here to the Acora Center, all three judges turned in identical scorecards of 80 to 72 in favor of the winner. By way of unanimous decision, from Isabela, Puerto Rico, the prodigy, Josue Vargas.
Your winner by unanimous decision, just as we thought, Josue Vargas. Good experience for him, Chris, against a tough opponent who had never been stopped, and he dominated from pillar to post. Worked the jab very well and did some great work to the body.
Yeah, you actually saw Josue mature as this fight went on.